So friends, in this session, we will discuss about liberalized remittance scheme. So all of you must have heard that India receives largest remittances in the world. So the people who are working outside India, the Indians, the people from India who are working outside India, they keep sending the money into India. And this is how we receive huge amount of remittances. So we have the people who are working in the Gulf countries, in the European countries, in the USA, South Asian countries, Southeast Asian countries, all around the world, the people are working from India. So this is about the inflow. Now coming to the other side, the outflow. So you may be having many payments to be done in the foreign exchange. So maybe you are planning to travel outside India, or you are planning to study outside India, or maybe you want to take care of your colleagues, your parents outside India. So there are a lot of transactions that you can take outside India. For that, you need to send the money, right? So earlier, this remittance was not easy. It was very, very restricted. In 2004, we made it very liberal. Liberal means relaxed. The rules and regulations are relaxed. So since 2004, we have allowed liberalized remittance scheme, right? So let us understand how does this work. So in the liberalized remittance scheme, we are saying that any individual any individual can send or make a payment up to $2.5 lakh, right? So this is the upper limit. During one financial year, that means between April to March. So any individual can send up to $2.5 lakh during one financial year, both for current account transaction and capital account transaction. That means either for capital or for current or for both. So individually or combinedly, the person can send up to $2.5 lakh. So this is the upper limit capped by the RBI. Now question arises, under what powers? So the powers are granted by the FEMA Act 2002. So there is a Foreign Exchange Management Act 2002, under which the Reserve Bank of India gets the power to regulate how much foreign exchange should go from outside India and how much can be allowed to come from outside India. So keeping in mind the larger economic interest of country, RBI puts some restrictions on how much amount one individual can send from India to outside India, right? So if we have huge foreign exchange reserves, then we can increase this upper limit. But if our foreign exchange reserves are not huge, then we have to, you know, keep this upper limit so that our foreign exchange reserves are not depleted suddenly, right? So the purpose of this liberalized remittance scheme is to allow individuals to involve into the allowed foreign exchange transactions. At the same time, there is upper limit so that we are able to manage the foreign exchange reserves into India, right? At the same time, these current account transactions and capital account transactions, there is a list of transactions which are allowed to be done from this liberalized remittance scheme. It is not that each and every transaction can be done. So please be careful. It is not that each and every transaction is allowed. There is a list of allowed transactions. That list we are going to see very soon in this session only, right? And also, there are some restricted purposes, or we have to keep in mind that this money is not being used for terrorism purpose, and this money is not being sent to those countries which are not complying with the FATF guidelines. So FATF is the Financial Action Task Force, which takes care of the terror financing, which keeps a very strict vigil on the money laundering and the terrorist financing. So if some country is non-compliant with respect to the FATF, then also this money should not be sent to that particular country, right? So we will see the detailed part of this liberalized remittance scheme now. The liberalized remittance scheme is a facility provided by the RBI for all resident individuals, right? So this is allowed for the resident individuals. So this is not for the NRIs. This is for the resident individuals. Please be careful. What is the meaning of NRI? NRI are those people who are citizens of India, but they are living outside India. They are residing outside India for the purpose of business, employment, etc. for a period of 182 days or more. Right? So if I am the citizen of India, but I go outside India, for example, to the USA, and I live in USA for more than 182 days, then I become NRI. In that case, this is not applicable. So this is applicable only in case of the resident. For all resident individuals to freely remit, right? So this is free remit up to a certain amount. So this amount, as of now, this is $2.5 lakhs. In terms of US dollar. So the amount can be sent in any current, by converting into any country in country's currency. But what is the point of discussion is that the upper limit will be calculated in terms of the US dollar itself for current and capital account purposes, or a combination of both. Hence, under the LRS, individuals are allowed to spend money in the foreign countries for specific purposes like education. So if you want to go for the higher education, tourism, you want to go to visit to some country, asset purchase, you want to buy some property outside India. The remittance limit is set for a financial year. So this limit is for the financial year. That means for a period of 12 months starting from April to the March next year. Currently, it is $2.5 lakh per person per financial year, right? So this is the current limit. So RBI ups limit under LRS to 2.5 lakh US dollar per person in a financial year. Now, regulations for the scheme are provided under the FEMA Act 1999, right? So this is the Foreign Exchange Management Act. So here, the RBI is responsible for managing the foreign exchange. When the country has sufficient foreign exchange reserves and the rupee is stable, RBI allows high remittances, right? So if we have huge foreign exchange reserve, for example, we have $1,000 billion of US reserve, foreign exchange reserve. In that case, RBI can even say that, okay, you can enjoy up to 10 lakh US dollar remittances per person per year, right? So if foreign exchange reserves are high, then higher remittances can be allowed, and vice versa. So if the foreign exchange are less, then this limit can also be reduced. Remittances can't be used. So there are some restrictions, right? So restrictions under the liberalized remittances scheme. Remittances can't be used for trading on the foreign exchange market. So you cannot trade, you cannot do the speculation, you cannot earn by selling and buying the foreign exchange through this LRS scheme. Margin or margin calls to overseas exchange and counterparties and the purchase of foreign currency convertible bonds. So these foreign currency convertible bonds are the issued by the companies of India abroad, and they can be converted, they are issued in the foreign currency and they can be converted, right? So these kind of bonds are also not allowed to purchase. Individuals are not allowed to send money to countries identified as non-cooperative jurisdictions by the Financial Action Task Force. So the FATF, if FATF identifies some country as the non-cooperative jurisdiction, then the individuals cannot send money to that particular country. Remittances are also prohibited to entities identified as posing the terrorist risk. So if any entity is identified as posing a terrorist risk, for example, ISIS. So I cannot donate the money to the ISIS because ISIS is basically identified as the posing terrorist risk. Now, I told you earlier that there is a set of transactions which are allowed. So if the money is being used for the capital account transaction, in the capital account, these are the list of transactions which are allowed. First kind of transaction is purchase of the property, opening a foreign currency account with the bank. So I can go to the foreign bank, I can open my account in the foreign currency, acquire and hold shares or debt instruments. So I can go and I can buy the shares of any foreign company. Acquisition of ESOPs. Acquisition means purchase, ESOP means employee stock option plan. So if I am working in some company and that company wants to issue own share to me at low cost, then that is called ESOP, employee stock option plan. Number five, investments in mutual funds, units, unrated debt securities. So this is basically the investment into the securities. Investment in venture capital funds, promissory notes. Venture capital funds means the funds which are investing into the new startups. Promissory notes, that is also one kind of security where the issuer of the promissory note is saying that I will give you certain amount after certain period of time, right? So this is promissory note. Setting up of wholly owned subsidiaries and joint ventures. Wholly owned means 100% owned. That means I am having the 100% ownership of the subsidiary and the joint venture. Joint venture means the ownership is less than 100%. So friends, don't get into the details of what is venture capital, what is wholly owned subsidiary. Just get a taste of the different kind of capital transactions which are allowed and which are not allowed. I am sure UPSC is not going to ask the question like which kind of transactions are allowed and which kind of transactions are not allowed. But still I am discussing so that you are much more clear about the concept. Number 7, loans to NRIs who are relatives. So even loans are part of the capital account transactions. Permissible current account transactions under the LRS. Private visits. So if I am visiting outside country, emigration, that means shifting from one country to another country, business trip, gift or donation, maintenance of close relatives. So I have my chacha, taya, mama, and I want to have the maintenance expenditure given to them. Going abroad on employment, facilities for the students pursuing studies abroad, and medical treatment. So these are the general purpose expenditures. You know, someone out of us, or you know, me, my family, any of them might have to expend this much of amount. So one person can spend up to 2.5 lakh US dollar in a particular financial year, right? So with this, I complete this session. I hope you enjoyed. you are more aware about the liberalized remittance scheme and you will take advantage as an aware citizen. Thank you very much. God bless you.